Good morning, students. Today we are going to study a mixed type of differential equation. It means right hand side of the differential equation you will have mixed function. It means type 1 of exponential function, type 2 of trigonometric function, or it may be of type 3 of polynomial in x. So this is a problem where type to find out the particular integral, we need to apply the concept of type 1 and type 2. Now here find out the auxiliary equation and find the roots. You will get the roots minus 1 and 1 by 2 plus or minus root 3 by 2i. Already in previous one of the problem we have solved it, how to find out the roots for this given differential equation. So based on that roots we wrote the complementary function. Now we find out the particular integral using inverse differential operator, 1 by d cube plus 1, and we know that cos 90 degree minus theta is nothing but sine theta. So convert it, otherwise it is difficult to take out the a value. Hence convert it, cos of 90 degree minus theta, it is in first quadrant. Always trigonometric function will change for 90 degree, cos to sine, and since it is in first quadrant you will get the positive value, positive sine x. So cos 90 degree minus theta is nothing but sine theta plus e to the power of x, as it is you write it down. So common denominator term is there, so separate it for the different function. So 1 by d cube plus 1 into sine x plus 1 by d cube plus 1 into e to the power of x. So we separated it since common denominator function we have. So let me take this as particular integral 1 and this as particular integral 2, p1, p2 we have written. Now take down p1, sine x by d cube plus 1. We know that it is of type 2. What is the condition? Recall it. To solve the particular integral with type 2, what is the replacement we have to do it? Replace d square by a square with minus sign. A value is 1, so 1 square with minus 1, it is minus 1. But here you don't have directly the d square term. You have d cube term, which can be written as d square into d plus 1. So in place of d square, substitute minus 1. So what you will get? 1 minus d. Further, to eliminate this d term, we can't replace for d. Yes or no? In type 2. So to bring a d square, what we will do? We will multiply and divide by its conjugate. So denominator term you are going to get it. It is in the form of a plus b into a minus b, which will be a square minus b square form. And numerator multiply to the bracket term. Sin x d into sin x. D into sin x will be what it is? Nothing but cos x. And here replacement of d square, what we should do it as? Minus 1. So minus minus become plus 1. 1 plus 1 will become 2. So this is a particular integral 1. It is nothing but revision of type 2. Now p2, let me take this part, p2. So which type of function you have? Exponential function. Exponential function means type 1. What is the condition for exponential function? Here replace d by a value. What is a value? Coefficient of x. A value is here 1. So wherever d is there, replace it as 1. So 1 plus 1 will become 2. Hence complete solution is yc plus yp. Complementary function plus particular integral. Okay. So you may get in the right hand side a mixed type of the previous types what we have studied it to find out the particular integral. Hence this is we call it as mixed type problems. Let me take up one more problem. Solve a second order differential equation. Observe in the right side you have mixed type of the functions, exponential, trigonometry, constant, so on. First, find out the complementary function. So to find out the complementary function, write this given differential equation using differential operator d, t square minus 4d plus 4 into y, and write outside function as it is. So from this bracket, we can write down the auxiliary equation equating it to 0. Take that in terms of different variable m. Using calculator, calculate the root. Now here you make a note, whenever roots are repeated, when you are calculating using calc, you are going to get only one value of m. When you solve in a calculator, a you will enter it as 1, b you will enter it as minus b, c you will minus 4, and c you will enter it as plus 4. Yes or no? So when you press equal button in a calculator, you will get a value of x1 as 2. Once again, if you press a button, you won't get x2 value. You will get again a value as 1. You just check it out in using calculator. What I am saying is, when you solve the equation using calc, when you enter a value as 1, b value as minus 4, c value as 4, and when you press it equal button, you get the in a calculator x1 as 2, and you won't get x2 value. Always remember, in a calculator, when roots are repeated, it will not show the another root. You need to understand when it is not showing x2 in a calculator, you understand that root, this previous what x1 you are getting, that will repeat. Hence, directly you can write it down x2 value as 2. So since it is second order, two values you should get. Remember that point. So you are getting it here, root, distinct and repeated. How to write the complementary function? So complementary function is written as, since e2 is repeated, c1 plus c2x into e to the power of 2x. This conditions you need to remember it as a formula. When roots are repeated, how to write the complementary function? When roots are distinct, how to write down? When roots are complex, how to write it down? That you need to practice it. Okay, need to remember it as a formula. Now coming to particular integral. So three functions are there in the right hand side, yes or no? So inverse differential operator applied for this function, plus inverse differential operator applied for this function, plus inverse differential operator should be applied for this function. That itself we have written it in this step. See here, inverse differential operator, that is 1 by f of d function, is written e to the power of 2x separately, cos 2x separately, 4 separately. How it is separated? In the right hand side equation they have given, it is e to the power of 2x cos 2x, 4 is separated with plus. So here also you have to take same sign. So let me denote it as p1, p2, p3. Let us find out that separately. P1 is type 1, yes or no? Exponential function comes for type 1. What is the condition for exponential function? Replace d by a. A value is 2. So 2 square is 4. Minus 4 to the 8 plus 4. So 4 plus 4 plus 8 minus 8. The denominator is going to be 0. If denominator is 0, what we need to do it? What we have studied it in the type 1? Introduce x. Differentiate the f of t function. Derivative of d square is 2d minus derivative of 4d is 4, and derivative of constant is 0. Again, what we need to do? Replace d by 2. 2 into 2, 4 minus 4. Again, denominator is going to be 0. So continue the process of introducing x, so it become x square, and differentiate the f of d, f dash of d function here. Derivative of 2d is 2, derivative of minus 4 is 0. So here directly by differentiating itself, the D term is eliminated from the answer. So this is the final answer for the P1. Now take it P2. What is P2? Cos 2x by d square minus 4d plus 4. It is of type 2. Yes. So what is the condition for type 2? Replace d square by a square. A value is 2, square is 4. With minus sign. I am repeating. Replace d square by a square. Then take minus sign. So only for d square you have to do the replacement. Here replacement is done. Minus 4 plus 4 get cancelled. What is left out? Minus 4d. It is not 0 here. You are getting it. Some terms of d. So minus 4d. And we know that the operator d stands for differentiation. But here how it is there? 1 by d form. So opposite, inverse of d. So opposite of differentiation, what it is? Integration. So 1 by d operator stands for integration. So what is the meaning of that? Minus 1 by 4 written as it is. For 1 by t integration is taken. Integrate cos 2x is the meaning of that notation. So integration of cos 2x is sin 2x by 2. So minus sign as it is. Sin 2x is written. Divided by 2. 4 2s becomes 8. So this is the P2 answer. Now coming to P3. What it is P3? P3 is nothing but what? Constant. Always when you get a constant term in the right hand side, try to convert it into the type 1 form. How we will convert? We will multiply the constant with e to the power of 0x. If only 4 is there, it is multiplied with 1. 4 into 1 is 4 itself. So in place of 1, we write it as e to the power of 0x. What is the condition for type 1? Replace d by a. So replace wherever d is there by 0. So what you will get? 4 by 4, which is equal to 1. So what is the final answer for YP? Complete solution is YC plus YP. YP answer is answer of P1, P2, P3. So substitute the final answer YC plus YP. So this is the complete solution of the given differential equation. Let me take it one more problem. See, this is also of the same kind. Only the difference, previous problem, it was 4. Here log 2 is nothing but constant. So how to convert it to type 1 form? And this is also type 1. What is this? Is it of type 1? No. E cube, x variable is not there here, yes or no? For a function of exponential, there is no x variable. So e cube is nothing but like 6 only, it is constant. 6 into e cube is constant. What is variable here? X. So what type it is? Only polynomial in x it is there, yes or no? X is nothing but polynomial function. So it is type 3. So this is type 3 to find out the particular integral. This is type 1. The constant is there, means also we are converting into type 1 by multiplying the constant with e to the power of 0x. Okay. So let me do it first part. That is finding the complementary function. Take auxiliary equation. This part and all you know to write it down now. Yes. Use a calculator. Since repeated root only one time in a displacement, you get a value as 3 in a calculator. But you need to understand, since it is square, that value is repeated. Okay. So when roots are repeated, how to write a complementary function? C1 plus C2x into e to the power of 3x. Now each term of the right hand side, separately write it down using the inverse differential operator. It is separated using inverse differential operator, and it is taken as P1, P2, P3. Let us take first P1. 6u cube 1 by d square minus 6d plus 9 into x. it is constant, so I have written left side of the inverse differential operator. If type 3 is there, means how we need to solve the particular integral? By expressing the in f of d function in the form of 1 plus x form. So to express as 1 plus x form, what we need to do it to get to 1, we take always constant outside the bracket. So this becomes 1, and here 9 is not there, so multiply it by 9 and divide it by 9. So multiplied 9 is taken outside the bracket and divided by 9 is kept as it is. Now x should be written as it is. In the next step, 1 by this bracket term, bring it to numerator. So how we can write this bracket term can be written as to the power of minus 1. And now it is in the binomial expansion form, 1 plus x whole to the power of minus 1. What is the formula? 1 plus x whole to the power of minus 1. It is 1 minus x plus x square plus x cube, etc. Since I have told that based on the power of x, what is the power of x till 1? So derivative of x exists where derivative of the d power also should be 1. More than that it is there, means the derivative of the polynomial is going to be 0. So here anyhow x term till d square, only d square of x will become 0. So squaring of this is not required. So expand with only 2 term. This binomial expansion, do it for only 2 term. 1 according to the formula minus. Here plus minus is there, means I told you to take a formula as 1 plus 1 minus x plus x square, alternate. That square term is not required. So what is x over here? It is nothing but d square minus 6d plus, d square minus 6d divided by 9 and multiply it by x. Now multiply x to the bracket, minus d square by 9x minus minus plus 6 by 9 dx. D square, 2 times derivative of x is 0. One time when you differentiate x, you are going to get it as 1. So 2 by 3 into 1. One more time when you differentiate, the derivative becomes 0. So what you will get, the 2 into e cube by 3, x plus 2 by 3 is the P1 answer. Next, P2. It is type 1. Replace wherever d is there, minus 2. I replaced it here. And see that you will get non-zero term. Next, P3 is constant. I told you to convert the constant terms are there to type 1 by multiplying the constant with e to the power of 0x. So wherever d is there, replace it by 0. So what you will get? Minus log 2 by 9. So now write the complete solution. Y equal to yc plus yp. Yp means which is? Particular integral 1, 2, 3. Substitute that answer, you get the final complete solution of the given differential equation. I will discuss some more problems in the next video. Practice it. This type of problems will majoritily asked in the exam, mixed type. You need to know here all the 3 types what we have studied it earlier to find out the particular integral. Thank you.